All right, hello everyone. Welcome to the stream. What is that? That is a giraffe. I forgot. I have giraffes in this world. Hello, Ricky Malbix, MC Craftmaster, Delta, Matix. You gotta sleep. Oh, I'm sorry. I know it's a little bit of a late stream. Okay, giraffes, break it up, you two. Break it up, you two. Already lagging my world. Can you make streams earlier? Certainly I can if I'm awake earlier. I know this is a little bit of a late stream. The VOD, the video on demand, will be up tomorrow if you want to check it out. It's, I don't think today's going to be super long of a stream either. It's like relatively simple, I think. So yeah. Which, by the way, this thing right here, this is actually another song that I'm working on. Members got to see it. Well, actually, I showed it in my Discord, so I might as well just show it to you here. This is also a secret new giraffe, new logic on the inside here. Stuff is happening and you don't know. You don't know about it. I did it in secret, but members might know about it. Members might know about what this guy is. Anyways, what time is it over there? It's right now. It's, about 6:30 PM. That's 18:30. Alright, so let's just go ahead and show you then, this, because I already showed the preview of this on my Discord. Let's pause this. YouTube music, no more. And let me know if you guys can actually recognize this tune. It's not the whole tune, and there's actually a mistake in there somewhere, so I have to redo it entirely, but... This is another video entirely. This is not what we're doing today. Just let me know if you can guess the tune. That's also, yeah. It's gonna be a little bit loud, actually. Do you hear that? Jeez, do you hear how loud that is? I cranked up my volume. It's my own fault, but I don't wanna deafen you guys. Anyone with headphones, beware. All right, it's not. I mean, it's loud. It's louder than me, I think. But hey, let me know if you can guess where this tune is from. That was just the first part of it. There's actually a lot more to it, but yeah, there was a little bit of it. Oh, yeah. Pedro and MC. Oh my goodness. You guys were very fast with that. Adventure Time? No, Delta. That was not Adventure Time. No. No. That was definitely not Adventure Time. Why? What do you mean why? All right, well, anyway, I'm just gonna cut this off, because I wanna copy this. I mean, I already have a music creation thing, but I wanna copy this. There we go. As my MIDI Maker 2. Minecraft music remix? Ah, jeez. All right, so let's put on the YouTube music again. Just while we're building. I'm going to have to turn that off eventually. Alright, so we'll weld this back down just because... Yeah, we're not going to be worrying about that one right now. No, Brent, I'm not doing that. How many instruments will I use? Just one, actually. Today, the reason why I'm doing this on a live stream is because we're doing a simple song. The song over there, I'm gonna use... The problem with Scrap Mechanic Music is that the tone generator isn't working. That's the big problem right now. Where is it? This guy. This part's not working. As soon as this part works, then I'll be able to make just about any song. Like polyphonic ringtones until we actually update this part to like import more sound types. Right now they're just sine wave, square wave, triangle, and sawtooth. So yeah, we can make video game sounds and arcade sounds if this actually works. But yeah, since we're limited to the smart tote bot, which is just like the regular tote bots, you don't really have like the full range of notes, and you don't have, you know, the percussion instruments don't you can't change the pitch. I don't know, there's all kinds of limitations. So today we're just doing a very simple, sort of like a, well, it came from a Game Boy game. It's a Pokemon, it's the Pokemon Center music. So that's just like a single note being played at any one time. So that makes it very easy. I only need one Smart Tote Bot Head then for the entire song, since it's only one note at any given time. Okay, so this, we're just gonna erase the entire thing. No more music in here. Even if I repress this, bam, it's all blank. All right, so if you haven't seen this build before, I've never actually made it a video for it or anything like that. This is what I used before, though, to make La Cucaracha, you know, this thing. Oh, I don't have it? How do I play you? How do I play you? Play. Yeah, stuff like that. And then the rest of this logic, I forgot. This was all for the car horn, so that you press it, and it just plays the audio and then stops. But you can press it and press it again to restart it. So, we were debated by the thumbnail, were you? Nah. No. I'm gonna be building. Well, yeah, I guess it's a different game, but the thumbnail is the Pokemon Center from the Game Boy games. So the music that when you're in there, when you're inside that building, that's what I'm gonna be creating today. Anyway, so all the things that I built before, like the keyboard cat song. What else did I build? I built La Cucaracha. Music. Where's my music build? I completely forget. What else did I build? I know I did another song, but I forget what it was. Keyboard Cat. Cucaracha. I can't for the life of me remember what other song. Oh, it was the Mr. Wobblequack. It was Mr. Wobblequack that I also used music stuff for. Good old Mr. Wobblequack. Oh, one of my best builds ever in any game ever. All right. So today, this is what I used to make all those songs in the past. Now that we have more mod tools, we should be able to do like even better songs in the future. But this is the old way that I used to do it. I think this entire side is just a testing ground where I just test what note, what instrument that I actually want, and the numbers to use it. And then I save whatever is being output from this test totebot right into one of these memory panels here. So I save whatever I'm recording, I save into the a copy into here. Incidentally, that's exactly what this thing down here is as well. It's just another copy memory panel. So whatever, I'm just gonna be making a music thing, and then at the end I'll just be able to cut this guy off and use it somewhere else. So that's what this is. That's what all this is. So here is just a very simple keyboard of all the things that are in any of the vanilla Toadbot heads. You just see here from C to C. It's not that great of a range, but you know, you press a button and it changes the number to the number of the note that we need to use. So now we have the number, just like I said up here. Let's say you wanted to use this Toadbot head. That sound inside the Smart Totebot head, you have to put in the number 4 as a black number to select this totebot. Like that's what I'm getting at. So we just need the numbers for the note and the totebot type, and then what, you know, all the notes are stored in a memory panel and we just loop through them. I totally didn't mean to sound for that to sound as complicated as it did, but anyway, how we write to the memory panel then. Is just with like this entire section here is how we write to the memory panel. So basically, all of these buttons, these are blank spaces. So this is, how do I actually explain this? First of all, I gotta stop this music so that I can listen to, I can't for the life of me remember how the song goes. Pokemon Center music. Alright. Do 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 do. That is gonna be the estimation for my BPM. So let's do for BPM, which by the way, I'm doing it like from the frame from the mindset of like ticks per second, I guess. So how much is like the smallest note, which I guess is a quarter note in the song. So if a quarter note lasts 7 ticks, then that's going to define the beats per minute. So let's go ahead and test that. And so these were blank spaces for the smallest. These are the quarter notes. These would be the half notes. These would be this is the whole note over here. So this is the one in between. anyway. so yeah, let's just write in a bunch of quarter notes, just like that. It just goes, see, we're already at 7 ticks in, because one quarter note took up 7 ticks. So, quarter note, quarter note, quarter note, quarter note, quarter note, quarter note, just a bunch like that. And then we just reset our position so I can test. Now that, for a BPM, that might be too fast. That is like slightly too fast. All right, slightly too fast. Let's try 8. We'll just reset everything. Oh wait, probably would help to rewind. Okay, I think that's actually the good, like the perfect BPM. Perfect. Okay, so now I'm just gonna look at a MIDI file, those like ringtone files, I guess, that old phones would use, because it actually shows me the notes, like the piano notes. So I select my piano note, select the note duration, and we should be good to go. This is actually only 13 minutes in the stream so far. Let's put the music, the other music back on. Alright, so now, one thing that I need to just keep in mind is, you smell food? What? See you later, Ricky, have a good night. Yeah, I know, it's a late stream, so tomorrow the video will be up, but, yeah, it's really late today. Alright, so the lowest note is F4 to G5, what the heck does that mean? Yeah, that should be the whole range of the song right there. Cool. All right, so then what? I think I need to. Okay, we're gonna use this guy in dance mode. I don't know if retro or dance bass, but I think I'm gonna do two tracks. I think I'm gonna do, you know, I can actually use the same, I can just use the same memory panel for two different tote bots. Yeah, this will work just nice. This will work nicely. Bass, percussion, synth, blip, bass 2. Aha. All right. Let's just get started, I guess. popping some stuff in, and yeah, that's the bass. That's the dance bass. All right, we'll do the bass track first. Actually, it doesn't matter because I can hook up a second tote bot. Yeah. Okay, let's make sure that guy is the number that I want it to be. Which number is that? Blip 2? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't think he wants to play the background part too. Yeah, no. The background music you hear right now, like the YouTube music, I'm gonna turn that off when we're actually done, when we're actually ready to listen. Wow, I can barely hear that one. I'm gonna turn this back to maybe synth, or let's try 3 or 7. I don't know. We'll go with that. I mean, it's not quite the sound that sounds like a Pokemon game, but we'll go with that sound. All right. So erase everything. Back to the start. We gotta start with A sharp, bam, A sharp, quarter note, bam, and it's that easy. And then F, quarter note, bam, then back to A sharp, bam, and then we gotta go to the next F over here, and that is double D sharp. That is a double. D. C. And that's an A. And that A is like this triple one. Okay, and then we also have like a empty space. 4 quarter notes long, which is this button here, and that puts us at 128. Nice, a nice round number, easy for me to remember. Okay, so let's go ahead then and pause the YouTube music, see what we have so far. I'm gonna show you guys just how easy this was. Hey Marcus, how's it going? No, the song you want to program is made with 2 melodies, one in the front and one in the background. It really depends on what Pokemon game you're what you're talking about. Like in early, whatever, let's just go back and let's listen to what we have so far. Sounds pretty good, right? Right now we're in the space between that little bit and the next little bit. So it's blank right now. Moonbow! Welcome to the giraffe herd, Moonbow! Oh my gosh! Evolutionary superior... Wait. Are giraffes just llamas, but like better llamas than llamas? Or are llamas like poser giraffes? Anyway, thanks for the membership, Moonbow. Welcome to the herd. All right, what was I doing? I completely lost track. Oh yeah. We got the first part of the song going. And that's it. So let's get back to 128. That's where we're at. There we go. All right, then we gotta enter A. And this is what we're gonna be doing for the next, I don't know, 15 to 20 minutes. We're just gonna be clicking buttons. And then the song will be done. It's actually a really simple way to make music in Scrap Mechanic. Gonna get to even more Scrap Mechanic. Nice. Dude, you gotta try, you like Moonbow, you like building with polygons, right? You gotta try the game RoboCo. I don't know if the developers sent you something about that. They sent, I think, everybody something about that, but that game has scalable polygons in all dimensions. You can scale 1x2x3, like any size that you want. It's very early stages in development, so it's not quite complete, and there's probably some parts missing, but definitely another, like, one of my favorite polygon builder games out of all of them. All of the games that I tried, that game definitely has polygon building like no other. But anyway, that's not what the stream is about. That's not what the stream is about. Main Assembly is another good game too, although that's a lot more like Dream Car Racing, in my opinion, with its building system. Anywho, the note A4. That's right, A quarter note. Bam. F quarter note. Bam. Another A. Bam. Then we go D5. That is the double. C. That is a double. Then A. Regular A. That's a quarter. A sharp. That's another quarter. And then D5. That is a triple. And then we just need another four blank spaces. And we're already in the next section. Durf, what other songs could you do? Just about any. Just about any songs. The only limitations right now is just that the tone generator is not working. Wait, where is it? This fancy part right here. This is not working. As soon as this works, then you can pretty much make any song ever. The only question then will be how it sounds. If it's gonna sound like an old-fashioned ringtone, or if it's actually gonna sound like an MP3. We'll get into that later though, like improving the sounds. If it actually works. So right now the only limitation is that we're stuck using Totebot sounds, like in-game sounds, and those just have limited range, limited options, that's all. So I know that doesn't really answer the question, but like, most iconic songs are probably capable of fitting within this range. Like most TV theme show songs, I don't know, what else is iconic? Maybe a national anthem? Is it possible to make a string instrument song? Maybe. Maybe with a tone generator in the future. Anyway, let's get back to this third section here. That's A4. Sharp. One quarter note. F. Down here. One quarter note. A sharp, quarter note. The high pitched F. That's a double. D sharp. D5. C5. And A. Regular A. Did I make those earlier A's as A sharp or A? That might have been a mistake that I did. Uh-oh. But anyway, that's got to be a triple. And then we got another four blank spaces. All right. I'm going to keep going. Yeah, because I'm just about like at the halfway point. So I'm going to keep going. A4. I'm saying A4. You guys have no idea what I'm talking about. A4 is the fourth A note on a piano, because there it repeats, you know, A B C D E F G, A B C D E F G. Anyway, F quarter note, A quarter note, D5 double. A4 quarter, and then A sharp is the another double. Oh, okay. Okay. And then here we have a double blank space and a quadruple blank space. All right, now we are at 512. That is a perfect number to stop on. Very easy to remember. And this is the first half of the song. So let's take a look and see how it sounds. Crank that up a little bit. Oh, this is gonna be great. All right, so back to 512. Let's do that other half of the song. So this is actually taking a lot less time than I thought it would. We're like less than a half hour into the stream and I'm pretty much done. There we go, 512. Now I need to make an entire polka center. That's true, right? I usually stream for 2 hours, so technically speaking, I have an hour and a half to do whatever. Make a small polka center. Dude, there's even Pokeballs in the mod pack beta. What am I doing with my life? And I have the logic to scan, where's the smart sensor? Where is it? I need to make these, oh, there it is. I can scan for what the object is and make sure that the Pokeballs are in the right slot and then do the little boop, 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 boop with the little lights up. I could totally make an epic Poke Center. Anyway, D's notes are sounding pretty epic. D, F, D sharp, F5, D, 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 C. Okay. D sharp for quarter note. F, quarter note. D sharp, quarter note. D5, quarter note. C3, half, and then half blank. All right, onto the next little thing. That's A4 all the way down here. Four, big boy. C5, another big boy. D5. Yeah, that's just a quarter note. D sharp, quarter note. D5, quarter note. C, quarter note. A sharp, half note. And then half blank. And on to the next section. D. Big boy. F. Big boy. I'm so close to being done the song. It's like, I don't know, like 12 more notes. D sharp. Quarter note. D. D sharp. F5. See, this is why number logic. Oh, and then finally the G. This is why number logic is superior to vanilla logic. Like, I wanted to make music in Scrap Mechanic, and I invented a tool for me to do it. Number logic is great. All right, and then the last section, let's get that F, F5 for a half note. D sharp, quarter note, quarter note. I hope I didn't make any mistakes. D sharp for a full big boy. D. D sharp. D. C. And then A sharp for a half note. And then a blank half notes to finish it off. So 1024 is the number of ticks of the entire song. Let's get out of this. Crank this back up. And let's hear our fantastical work. Also, there's one thing that we can do. Yeah, we have this stuff here. I'm gonna make this repeat automatically. Well, what am I doing? I'm going the long way around. There we go. Okay, so if white is greater than or equal to... Oh my gosh, it's weird playing with the game sound cranked up this much. I'm not used to it. I'm doing really lazy things. Hold on a sec. All right. So, inside a math block just so that I can write that number to the memory panel. There we go. So, whenever that thing is equal to or greater than, we're just gonna give this guy... We're just gonna make it... Go right to this tick button. Alright. I don't even know if that repeat thing is actually gonna work the way it should, but hey, let's... the melody is 1 kilobyte or something like that. Oh, nice. Dragon King, how's it going, man? Hey, it's been a while since you showed up. I didn't mean for that to sound like, where were you? Alright, so let's just see how this sounds. No, it didn't repeat. but overall, that was perfect. I could not have asked for that to be played any better. Actually, you know what I could ask for? You know what I could ask for is just changing up the tote bot things and seeing what they sound like. But yeah, this repeat thing, I gotta fix that like right now. Should be. I know, I gotta put a logic gate in between, like just a regular logic gate. So whenever that activates, bam, it activates a logic. Which should reset the circuit. Yeah, and that's the only input. That's the only input for that tick button, so it should work. Let's try that again. I just want it to repeat, like on a loop, like the Game Boy does. Derpa derpa derp. Derpa derpa derp. Derp derp derp. All right, I mean, the timing is like slightly off. I can hear that extra tick. that the repeat logic takes to actually repeat. I don't know, I'm gonna try listening to it again, just because maybe it's my OCD. Nah, it's alright. It's alright. Hey, I'm going to bed, you made it! beeps, beeps and boops. Oh my gosh, what nightmare is this? Ah, the challenge ball sound doesn't work. All right. So here's my thinking then, I guess. We're gonna hook all these guys up, all of them. And then we're each gonna give them just their own custom thing that we can choose. And then we'll do some experiments. See how many tote bots are we actually gonna use? Okay, stop for a sec. Okay. This guy. There you go. This is the note information. We need to put this guy in all of these. They're all getting the same track. It's a very simple song, so. And then we gotta do these note informations. Which tote bot are these guys gonna play? And make sure those are painted black. Alright, so 1, 1, 1. Those are all the base tote bots. Let's go. It's really loud. I think, oh my gosh. Alright, hopefully it's not too loud. Too bad though. This combination of tote bots? Okay, one regular bass, one synth. One treble dance? That's the regular piano. But where's the beep boop? In there. The dance bass. Wait, wasn't this the piano? No, that was the regular bass. Okay. Woof. Derf, we need a nice drum to go with it. Really? I mean, I could always just toss on a drum. Just like this. But I have no idea what notes, like the numbers being fed into this guy. They're not gonna be like proper drum track stuff. I have no idea what's snare, what's not. Actually, let's stop that for now. There we go. I have no idea what's... This this percussion track? No. Just no. Is that better? Is that better for percussion? New member soon, TM? Wait, what? Oh, was there a new member in the chat and I didn't even see it? I'm sorry. Wait, no, there was Moonbow. Yeah, I see the notifications, it was just that. What's going on? Oh, I see going to bed. I'm gonna have to talk to you after the stream. Anyway. No, I meant new Discord members. Ah, okay. Okay, that makes sense. Alright, let's stop this. Oh my gosh, I need to think. No percussion, though. No percussion. Yeah, and I should just be able to chop this off. So let's do that. Wait, before we just go ahead and do that. Yeah, no, that's alright, that's alright. Let's just go in and do that. Okay. So this is usually what I do. Oh my gosh, let's take that audio back down to normal levels and bring the music back. Okay, so this is usually what I do when I'm ready to finalize a music thing. I just take the saved cartridge. I need a counter to be the actual music position. I need another counter, or I could probably just cut this stuff off actually. Alright, so now I'll know, I hope this is the right direction. I don't know which one's which. Cool. I mean, it doesn't really matter. Cool. Okay. Actually, I should be able to just paint this white and hook that straight up into this. Easy peasy. Easy peasy. Okay, let's get a main switch out here. We might actually end up replacing that too. All right, tote bots. I have five up there? All right. Am I actually using six different instruments? I don't even remember. I don't remember. All right. Let's get that button out here just so that I can test. You, what do you sound like? The regular bass, that's one of you that I need. So then the next one, why did I connect all of these? I don't... The next one that I need is the dance bass, which is number 3, 4, 5. and that is... Wait, what? Oh, it would help if I actually connected them, right? Okay. All right. All right. Okay, that is correct. Let's move on. This should be number 5, right? Nothing happens right now because it has no number, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go, that's the bass that I wanted. Alright, and then next we have probably a little beep boop. One of those regular beep boops, like number 2, I think. No, number 3. I think so. I can't exactly... Wait, can I still play it? Yeah, it's in there. Then we got a synth, which is just number 3. Oh, wait. No, I got that wrong. All right, so then that's the synth. Number 4 is the blip. Yeah, that's the other treble thing that I wanted in there. Okay, next, we're gonna do a dance blip, I think. I completely forget. And I just heard it, like, 15 seconds ago. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8, I think. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hey, Eric, how's it going? There we go. Yeah. What's that last sound that I wanted? Was it just the synth? So that's 7? I have no idea. I have no idea. Let's figure it out. And, figure it out? What am I saying? Let's just go with it. And we'll see from there. So yeah, that's it, right? Turn on the thing. This is painted white because this is the note information. There we go. Just check real quick. Logic. Right, they need a logic input. All of them do. So, logic, number, okay. Okay, just hook up the main switch, and we're good to go. And this is the compressed version of the exact same thing that I built. The song, all the instruments and everything, ready to go, anytime. Derp-a-derp-a-derp. I forgot. This game has Doppler effects. Alright, let's go ahead and... just make sure that's reset back to 0. Just in case, actually, before I save it. We're gonna add that reset button. Isn't there already a reset button? Whatever. Whatever. Okay. So yeah, reset. And then this is Poke Center Music in all caps. Okay, so one thing, I forgot this game actually has like a Doppler effect. Let's pull out an engine. Any old engine, doesn't really matter. Put a bearing, there we go. Get rid of all this extra weight so we can swing this thing around. Yeah, just like that. This isn't gonna be weird at all. All right. All the way out here, just for my own convenience. Is this the Pokemon Center? Let's try even faster. It doesn't even sound anything like it anymore. Oh, that's so weird. It just gets completely unrecognizable so quickly. Anyway, max speed, I can't do it with this thing in the way. Now I can. Now I can. Oh, just no. This is like the barely recognizable area. Like, I know every time I play a video game, I tend to like break it within the first hour that I play it. But I thought me making Digital Music and Scrap Mechanic was a game that I made up. And I managed to break it too. All right. Actually, no, I didn't make up making Music and Scrap Mechanic. Music and Scrap Mechanic has been around for a long time, since Sensors and Totebots. This is gonna be my morning alarm? Okay. Yeah, if you wanna wake up in a cold sweat, thinking, oh no, have my Pokemon been healed? Oh yeah, that's right. I gotta build a Poke Center. Let's do that. Let's build a Poke Center. Now that we have the music. One thing though that I actually really I want. I'm gonna make the on-off thing. The music's gonna start as soon as you walk in. That's what's gonna happen. It's gotta be automatic. Don't forget the Pokemon. I mean, I could, instead of building a Poke Center, I could just build like a giant Pikachu and stuff the music inside that. Which would you guys prefer? What do you think? Pikachu or Poke Center that the music starts when you walk in? I You know, to be honest, I'm thinking Pikachu myself, actually, because, what does the Poke Center look like? Stuff the Pokemon. You guys are saying Pikachu anyway. All right. I think I have the polygons with me. We'll try building a Pikachu. What's the worst that's gonna happen? It's gonna come out as a Raichu? Pika P. At least the healing Pokemon behind the counter. Oh no, what's that? Chansey, the Pokemon. You know, one of the Pokemon games that I played was, Pokemon Snap. That, where you gotta take photos of Pokemon. You capture them in another way. And, I broke that game too. That was a really long time ago, but I broke that game. There's a level where there's like you're in a minecart. You're in a minecart like in all the levels, and you're just going on a track. But one of the levels has like a giant egg that's blocking the track, so you actually get stuck on it. And unless you actually like throw things at it to get the egg out of the way, you don't move. And that's just supposed to be like a normal obstacle in the game. Just like, good job, you got past the egg. But turns out that you can just stop at the egg there and then throw your bait to the side of the track and it will just attract an infinite number of Charmanders. Oh my goodness, I got the most amazing photo in the history of that game ever because it was quite literally one single Charmander. I'm nerding out about a game that none of you probably play. But anyway. There's a single Charmander with the apple that I just threw right for him. And he was jumping up in excitement midair in the photo. And then all around him was a circle of just more Charmanders looking at the apple that the other one was excited about. It was literally I've never seen a better Pokemon Snap photo. Not to toot my own horn or anything, but I did that. You know when McDonald's used to have Nintendo 64s? I did that. It wasn't even at a McDonald's, actually. I think it was at, like, a Blockbuster or some video game rental place. I don't know. It was at one of those... it wasn't even my Nintendo. So I left it there. And whoever now has that photo saved on a cartridge of Pokemon Snap that was probably sold to someone else as a used copy. Durf, the clown car is the worst that can happen. What? The clown car is the worst? What do you mean? I'm kind of confused. Okay, Pikachu. Pika P. We're gonna build him very octagonal. So we need all these, all these things right here. Even with or odd width. Pika P, we're going even width. That's how I make my decisions. I just kind of flex the Pikachu energy. Oh, that is definitely wrong. I didn't even grab the wedge. Man, I'm a dingus. That is no longer attached. That is a bad thing. Okay. This guy, right? Yeah, that'll work. Sorta. Durf, Durf, the clown car was creepy. Oh yeah, the eyes for the clown car. I know. Pika Durf. How's it going, TQC1? And Eli Mason. I remember you. I built Baby Yoda into floating crib. Nice. Yeah, I think I was like, go give him a crib. And some people did. Alright, yeah, this is a super professional Pika build. Anybody remember what Pikachu actually looks like? Should probably pull up a photo or something. Also, I just realized I'm probably not going to be able to fit that music inside this Pikachu. Ah, jeez. Hopefully I'm not going to be making him too thick. Pikachu, I feel like he has a belly, so I'm giving him a belly. Gotta say, though, he's already taken form. Tail. How does the tail look? I don't remember the colors at all. Build an actual steam locomotive in a stream? I would give tons of tips and ideas. Sure, I mean, there isn't steam in Scrap Mechanics, so I'm not sure. There's no physics for that. Should be able to use some of this stuff, right? Oh no, I build him even with, like, a dingus. I clearly don't know what I'm doing, guys. Okay, there we go. That looks like I'm doing something almost right. almost right. Like, so close to being definitely not right. let me just go get a picture of Pikachu. Bedman donated $129. I need mental help. Alright. Well, if you actually need mental help, and that's not a joke, there's usually different like programs that you can find through schools and stuff like that, or literally you can just like walk into a hospital and just it depends. I don't even know what country you live in or like the healthcare plan or anything like that, because like in Canada you can just like if you break an arm or something, you can literally just call the police. They're gonna use their time and energy and gas money and all that to pick you up in an ambulance, to take you to the hospital and get you all casted up, x-rayed, whatever they need to do to fix you up on drugs and everything, all on taxpayer money. You don't pay a dime. That's Canadian healthcare for you. What was I doing? I was getting a picture of Pikachu. Yeah. So if you actually have like an issue, like if you actually have something that you need to, I don't know, get taken care of, I guess. Like there's a lot of different options and different contexts. Like if generally speaking, if it's just like you're struggling in school type of thing, talk to the counselor, because they're usually, schools have like a psychologist on hand for counseling. For, you know, with students and trying to help them through hard times and stuff. Yeah. If you require some other kind of mental assistance, like you feel like you are disabled in society, that's a different story entirely. You need to talk to, you basically need to get yourself tested for disabilities. So then if you have a valid disability, then like governments usually just give you help for that. And I don't know, just in general, I guess. I mean, I don't wanna, mental health stuff is usually like private stuff, but in general, I'm also kind of a I don't know. Do I offer, just say, hey, send me a DM on Discord and I'll see if I can help you with your issue? Because, like, I don't know. Some people appreciate, the outlook that I give to them and it helps them, but I guess that's not going to apply to everyone, or maybe I can't help, so that's it. I don't want to give any, like, false impressions. I have no idea. I just hope it all works out for you, Bedman. And, you know, when it comes right down to it, you're still here, right? That's really what counts. You're still around and kicking. So just keep on going. Because there's another version of you that is very happy and glad that you stayed alive. You know? In the future. He's gonna be all the things that... Whatever. Anyway... Hi, I just noticed the mod pack is open source now. Nice. What? Lord MZTE, the mod pack was technically always open source, but also it's less open source now than it was before, so I'm really confused at what you're talking about. It's really funny. What are you even talking about right now? Open source? You could always get the source for the mod pack. Milk on a bed. At least this stream is the best thing that has happened to me today. Oh. I don't know. I mean, At least, I guess. I don't know. For Pikachu's legs. He has some big honkin' thighs. He's got some thick boy thighs. But let's also give him those little mousy jumper legs that he has. Does that work? I think that works. That is the... Alright, it works. I mean, you know when those like lazy solutions just... are exactly what you need. Oh, this is such a... It looks like a bunny, I know. I mean, Pikachu is sort of a bunny, right? Not really, but... What am I gonna do here? Durf, what would you say the meaning of life is? I would say that you're asking the wrong question. And I know that's like a little bit of a weird concept because everybody basically understands what that question is intending to ask. But if you pay very close attention to the definitions of the words, that's not even what you're curious about. You're not curious about meaning of life. You're more or less asking why existence exists in the first place, why you are able to perceive existence. And so the question should be, what is the purpose of existence? Because then that's going to answer that question for you. Yeah, I'm sorry. Whatever that donation was, I was not able to read it in time. It's really small font on the screen that it shows up, and I wasn't able to read it. Anyway, so then the question of... Okay. So for those that are actually curious about like the full discussion of what that is, because like I actually have somewhat of an answer for that, that's going to be on my third channel, Durfology, which I never actually start and never actually started. And yes, I think it's a stupid name for a channel. Durfology, it sounds like incredibly, what is it? Arrogant or like egotistical? Like it's like Durfology is the religion of the meaning of life or science or something. Like it's so dumb. But no. The point, something I'm also going to explain in the intro video for that channel is that like the what else do you call it when you spend a lot of your lifetime thinking about a lot of things, and then you come to the realization of like certain patterns and ways of thinking that you can explain to other people that actually benefit them? What do you call that? Is there a name for that? I don't know if there's a name for that. So. And you know, then you look at words like biology or, you know, astrology, and it's like the ology part is just the study of, right? It is a philosophical channel, yes. But I'm going to be applying a lot of like actual facts and science to the guru. Like, yeah, those are all. I don't know. So just like my name, Durf. Like, what does Durf mean? It can mean literally anything. So. I just, you know, slap some stuff together. Durfology, there you go, that's what it is. But yeah, I think in general, like, so to give you guys an idea, you can describe existence in, like, I guess several components, I guess. So I described it as, like, there is existence, right? And then you also have perception. Oh wait, no, there's also, I guess there's also the implication of reality itself. So something that's separate from yourself that you perceive as like outside of your control or you don't really have an effect. Bed is milk, man. Now donated $1. Your streams are always so fun. What is with all these names? Someone is just donating $1, renaming themselves. So Durfology is the study of Durf. Not quite, maybe. I don't know. It might be the study of my perception of certain questions, existential questions or something like that. Anyway, yeah, that's you, I'm going to bed. That's you. I figured. Yeah, nobody's that ballin' to just be renaming accounts like that for donations. This is a dumb looking Pikachu. I'm upset with this. I don't like it. But I gotta paint, you know, the rest of those stripes on him. He's got at least two of those back there, right? Anywho, so let's say you have, this is not actually, like, useful for the conversation or the video or anything, the non-existent video, but, make it taller. No, we still gotta add the head. We're still building the head. Don't worry about it. He's gonna be taller. Right. So, let's say that there's just, let's assume that there is a reality, a world that is separate from our perception of that world. Which, in itself, that sentence that I just said gave the implication that you can interpret reality in another way, where, you know the belief that some people have where you, if you believe it hard enough, then it's gonna happen type of belief? So that's like the two different ways that I'm sort of flipping between on how to perceive reality. Anyway, let's assume that there is a world, a reality world, all right? And then that reality, you have a perception of it, but your perception is not of the entire reality. It is just of a portion of it. You're filtering the entirety of reality down into just what you perceive. So then from that, that is all, again, filtered into, like, down even further into your mind and thoughts. So if there was, like, this huge reality world of everything, you're filtering it down just into your perception. And then everything that you perceive, you filter down into your thoughts and what you actually think about. So just in general, be more thoughtful than not thoughtful. Think more than not thinking. And in general, you're gonna come up with, I don't know, insights. This sounds so, like, obvious and backwards. Like, duh, if you think a lot, you're gonna get a lot of insight. Duh. Anyway. So, what am I doing here? I think I'm also gonna give him like a little hunchback type thing. Right here. Did not do that right. Okay, and then, yeah, we're giving him, like a little fold of fat, back of the neck fold. I made a fat Pikachu. Oh, jeez. Derf, look up a game called Evertech Sandbox. It's like Scrap Mechanic, but before has some things missing. Marcus Hung says, I don't think at all. I think everyone thinks relatively the same amount. I think, however, it's merely a measure of how much you are going to be aware of what you're doing. So think about someone that is, there's a concept in psychology, by the way, where it's philosophy, I guess, both. The term is like philosophical zombie, where someone, you won't be able to tell them apart between a real person or a philosophical zombie, because externally they are the exact same. So the concept of a philosophical zombie is that it's like, you can, another analogy would be like a body without a soul, but it's still walking around and talking around and doing everything, working every day. Feeling like the body feels pain and cries and happiness and all the things that a human does, but then there's just no like internal thought to actually experience that. So that's the concept of a philosophical zombie. And basically there's another belief where, again, under the assumption that sort of thing is true, if you spend your time thinking, using that brain of yours, flexing those muscles, then you become more and more aware of as a person. You get to observe and realize more of like the things that you perceive. You're just able to do so much more with it. So if you indulge in the practice of not thinking, then that's moving closer and closer towards that philosophical zombie type of thing. right? Where think about someone who's like so depressed on the inside that they just want to shut down. That's the type of thing that I'm talking about. You don't want to be like that. You want to use that brain of yours. You want to get more power. You want to be able to do things with your life and your livelihood. You know, you don't want to shut down like that. Anyway, let's get think less, stupid more. See, you guys, this is why I haven't started the channel yet. I'm not exactly a speaker, you know what I mean? But you guys can summarize my words into a simple sentence like that. Oh boy. You guys need to be doing this for me. Guys, why, like, my Pikachu looks disgusting. Come on. It's not even the right colors that I'm using. It's so bad. Where was that picture of Pikachu that I never actually got? There we go. I finally have a picture of Pikachu. Derf, too much power is bad. King George III is an example. That's why the Founding Fathers fought to create the US. Nope, that's actually incorrect. What you're referring to is power amongst other beings in the world. What I'm referring to is power to control your being. So, like, you can consider it like self-control, or the actual ability to choose what you are doing instead of being subject to your subconscious patterns. That's what I'm talking about. So, for example, then, if King George III actually had this type of power, then he wouldn't have been... He basically would have been aware of himself abusing the royal power that he had. I don't know how else to describe it. I don't know the word for it. But it's a different thing entirely. Here's the thing that I think it comes down to, like, if you're really dumb, you're inevitably just going to be like a good person, I guess. Because it's very difficult for you to realize the opportunity to take advantage of someone else or something like that. So just in general, if you're dumb, if you lack ability, you're generally not going to be a bad person. And then, as sort of like a rule of thumb, the more intelligent you get, then the more aware of things you are, and yes, the more you can take advantage, and the more evil you can be. It doesn't mean you are going to be evil, but it just means that you have more ability to be good or evil. And then I think after you get past a certain point of beyond that as well, I think then some of the answers on what is actually good or bad sort of become more obvious as you actually just start to think more. If you were to like measure, can I like draw this with paint or something to show you guys? If you were to have like a scale, the milkman has quit, donated $1, just says no. All right, I don't know what no means, but okay. So if you were to put this side down here as like impossibly dumb intelligence, and over here as like impossibly smart intelligence. Like, literally, no human will ever get here, and no human will ever get there. I think between here and here, it's just like a... It's like a relationship like this. Sort of like a cone that goes outwards. So, when you're right here, very close to no capability, no intelligence, no awareness, you have very little ability to actually affect the world around you. Or I guess the responsibility of your actions, I guess is one way to put it. And then if you're closer on this scale, You know, it's much, much greater. The things that you can affect, the things that you can design, and, you know, like, think about, as far as I know, there isn't such a thing as a stupid sociopath. For this reason exactly, right? Like, they would not be able to actually learn human behavior to the degree of taking advantage of it. So there's no such thing as a stupid sociopath, but there is such thing as a smart sociopath, because I don't know. Anyway, let's actually get to finishing this Pikachu. This is taking way too long, and I don't know what to do about the tail yet. I might have to cut him in half and make him thicker the other way, horizontally thicker. Yeah, because this is a weird head shape. This is bad. This is just bad. Let's do the thing that I said I was gonna do. All right, come here, Pikachu. You're gonna get one block that I deleted, one block extra. Yeah, and now you're odd width. Slightly better, but not really. Anyway. Anybody else got any more existential questions that I'm definitely not going to remember to actually do a video on whenever I start that channel that I'm never starting? The Milkman is now Bedman Lamau. You should do a stream where you play with fans. No, I'm going to be doing a stream. I'm going to be doing a stream soon. I don't know if it's going to be a live stream, actually. But I will record it, at least, and put it on YouTube. I'll be doing a thing, though, a game with members, Patreon supporters, whoever, any of my supporters. I'll invite them for, you know, I was going to do that crouch running race. That idea is, there's a few ideas that I could do. Okay, this is still a fat Pikachu, but... Mason Foster, if you do that channel, I would be willing to discuss many things. Shoot me a message if and when. Dude, you just gotta, just subscribe to it, man. The channel exists, I just haven't posted to it. Durf, what happened during the Big Bang? Lots of things could have happened during the Big Bang. So there's actually an interesting discussion about what science seems to think happens, and I think, like, there's so much that, in all the explanations that you hear about, like, this happened at the Big Bang, blah, 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 they don't mention, I don't know, I think a lot of scientists today are kind of dumb. no offense. Not that I'm, again, like, I'm not trying to sound like I'm, you know, like I know better than them or anything, because that's definitely not the case. There's very different skill sets, actually. The ability to just, like, think abstractly in itself is a skill that anyone can possess regardless of their, like, scientific knowledge or ability. So if there's actually a scientist that's, like, struggling to make a theory work, then it's quite possible that somebody that knows nothing about science can help them actually flex the brain muscles that they need to get to a working theory. That's the only part that I meant, that some scientists today are really they're not dumb, okay? They're not stupid, but it's like they get stuck in a rut with how they think sometimes. So anyway, during the Big Bang, for example, not a single scientist even considers something like how that much energy in that much space-time affects time, something like time dilation, and then how that will look to us billions and billions of years in the future, or something as simple as just the region of space that we're in. The region of space-time that we're in, the region of the universe that we're in, could literally be isolated in terms of, like, all the universal constants that we observe. And I know there's, like, some... There's a lot of theories that argue for and against that sort of thing. Because, like, some universal constants are supposed to be the same everywhere, no matter what. That's why they're universal constants, right? But... if we can't see past the observable universe, it's very possible that we cannot observe the thing that changes those universal constants. So just little things like that kind of irk me about some of the theories that scientists are like, oh, this is the most accepted theory today. And like, no, it's got a huge freaking hole in it. You can't just accept that. Whatever. It's not, anyway, I'm going to bed. What are you saying? Please become a member, get us to 100 members so Durf does it. Yeah, that's right, a face reveal. So when did Durf merge with Durfology? When I never posted the... That's right, Mason. Name of the channel is called Durfology. Can't find the channel? Go into my Discord. My Discord, there is literally a text channel called Durfology that has the link to the YouTube channel. I don't know if I actually linked it to my thing. I don't know if I actually linked it to my channel. Anyway, Odd Width was definitely a good choice because I need to do the eyeballs. And this is looking so bad, guys. Why do you guys make me build a Pikachu? The Pokemon Center was a good idea. Why did I do this? You guys hear that? There's some incredibly loud sirens. Usually not that loud. Pika! Oh my god, I can't do the voice crack that that Pikachu does. What comes in the afterlife? Oh, that's an excellent question to ask, actually. So the way that I would start that question is, or the way that I start answering that question is actually looking into where the heck people even get answers to that question. Because there are already answers to that question, right? People can already tell you, oh, this and this happens. So where the heck do they get those answers from? And then there's several places. It's really all over the place. So, but then, anyway, the song, please. Yeah, you want to hear the song? Let's hear the song. It's been a while. It's about time. Let's pull out that song again. Poke Center music. Alright, so then that'll just go. This will be the new stream music. Oh wait, I just stopped it. Whoops. All right, so that'll just be going while I'm building. Forever and ever. Yeah, Marcus, you're asking a lot of great questions for Durfology, and it's unfortunate. Like, dude, I'm having trouble enough running two YouTube channels as is. Please, please. So, I'll get to it when I can. I'm sorry that it, like, I know a lot of people are actually, like, some people are actually mad at me for that, because it's like, I want the answers, Durf, but that, I don't know. It's, I have things to do, I have bills to pay, I can't, I mean, maybe if I started that YouTube channel and it, like, just overtook, like, it paid all my bills overnight, then yeah, I just switch over to that channel. Durf, can you check? I'll get to all the mess. I got a flood of messages. Are they all from you? I'm gonna get to them after my stream. I just don't read DMs during streams, man. It's not something that's worth doing. Okay, Pikachu. I need a image of Pikachu. The thing that I finally pulled up. His ears. Let's just give him. Oh no, he looks like a bunny. He looks like a bunny. He doesn't look like a mouse. He looks like a bunny. It definitely looks like a bunny. What is wrong with me? Oh, now that just makes him look like a bumblebee. We're gonna take that last stripe out. The ears, though, like, really bug me. I mean, if that's the ears that he's gonna be with, then... This Pikachu looks so derpy. Why? Why? Pika! Oh my gosh. Alright, we gotta get this tail going. Derpichu, I know, right? Gotta get this tail going. So now that he's odd width, I can actually use these wing pieces the way that I wanted to. That looks like the direction that I want that to go in. There's gotta be, I know there's a way to use these smartly. Like, more intelligent than my use of English. There we go, I think that's it. I don't know. All right, let's get rid of the song. Oh boy, how did people play Game Boy back in the day? Well, that was just inside the Pokemon Center, so the next song, actually, you know, we gotta make some of the actual Pokemon town songs. Pokemon town songs would be a great thing to do. I just want a Zigzag. That's really all I want. Is it so hard to get a Zigzag with some wedges? Come on, look at that. That looks like a Zigzag. Sorta not really. Wait, what? How does... That looks like a half block. What did I just build? What? Oh, okay. I mean, that is a pretty dang looking, good looking tail. We're gonna make it a block thick too. We're not using this these wing parts anymore. Problem is, how do I attach this to the buttocks? I mean, I could do that. Yeah, let's do that. Going up. Going up. Going up. There we go. There we go. I'm getting it. I'm getting it. Pikachu. Wait, that's not how I do it. There we go. Then we go back up. Like this. Like this. And last one. Come on. There we go. Give him a nice big old tail. Can't really change, can't really do anything about the size. Nah. There we go. We'll just go with that. So he does have a brown base on the tail. Something like that. Which is actually really great that it does, that I used polygons there for that. And then the rest is just yellow. Easy peasy. Easy peasy. A lot of people forget that there's actually not, like, some people put, like, a black thing there, just like his ears. But, you know, I'm gonna leave the ears derpy like they are, because that's really funny to me. And I think that's it. I think that's it. So the question is, can we even fit the music inside this Pikachu that I built? I don't think so. I really don't think so. Oh, I should probably paint his... And make it all brown. All right. All right, next stream, scrap mechanic stream, I'll actually build something, I don't know, that isn't this. Pika derp. Pika pia, sure. Share, we're sharing that to the workshop, why not? Durf, you actually made a good Pikachu. Oh, and Durf, can you upload it to the workshop? Yeah, I'm gonna be uploading all of this to the workshop today. What's going on? What's going on? My scrap mechanic is dying. Trying to upload Pika Derp. Did it literally die? Wait, what? Pika Derp doesn't even have like a load share button? My scrap mechanic actually, my lift is broken, what? My lift is broken! How? Orienter? Orienter is setting pose weight. Brent, I'm gonna... Peek-a-derp? Let's delete that workshop listing. And... Let's try that again. Blame Brent's typical derp. No, well, okay, if you saw the error on screen. Guys, I can explain it to you. I'm not just being hard on Brent, you know, for the lols. Set that visibility to public. There we go. Okay. So we make like lots of mod parts. Yeah. That's the thing that we do, right? So, anyway, this here, you can see that there's an argument, bad argument, to set pose weight. So set pose weight, there's like a lot of different things that mod makers can do in the game. It's like, spawn this thing over here, move this thing over here, apply a force to that thing over there, color the thing this thing. Like, there's just a lot of actions that you can do in the game, right? And that's the part that Brent writes. No, Scrap Mechanical Labs. Hey, how's it going? Good to see you, man. You're back, right? Are you back? Are you gonna come back? Coming back for a survival mode? Survival mode's gonna release this month. This month, Scrap Mechanical Labs. What are you gonna do? You're gonna survive the lab. Anyway. So Brent is just the guy that writes the scripts, right? So the reason why I blame him for a lot of things is because, generally speaking, if I wrote the scripts, like I have programming experience that I know how to avoid certain issues, like this one exactly. I know exactly how to avoid and never get this issue ever again, because but anyway, I guess when did Brent start programming? It must have been like a few years ago, so there's still things that he picks up on here and there. So the main thing, then, the key lesson, I guess, for this error would be, whenever you're going to use anything for the game, like any component of the game, whenever you're going to tell the game to do something, in this case, set pose weight, you got to make sure that whatever you're giving it to, whatever you're feeding this, it has to be in a format that the thing is ready to use. And that's just one simple step that you can do just before you actually make the call. Just make sure the thing that you're going to put into the call is the right format. So in this case, it would just be a very, very simple if statement. If number is infinite, change it to something like zero or some debug value or a failsafe so that the game doesn't break like this. Because whenever you see an error happen like this, you usually have to exit your world and then join back in again. So that's the type of thing that I'm talking about. Blame Brent. No. Brent's not the whipping boy of the mod crew. He's actually, everyone in the mod, there's a few people, I think MJM is probably like the best mod maker, I think, in the entirety of Scrap Mechanic. Like, he can do literally anything. He can write scripts, he can make models, he can animate models, he can do anything. Brent, for example, he doesn't like to make model, or he doesn't get into modeling, he doesn't make textures or stuff like that. So I guess, like, when we're forming a team, just in general, we're trying to make like the best mods for the game in general. Like, it's not really about who's making them, or I don't know. That's generally why you don't see like a mod pack sponsored mod for like specific people, right? Like, we don't make vanity mods like that. It's more about just making the game better for everyone. Anyway, so Brent's not necessarily the whipping boy. He's actually taking a lot of the scripting work off of me from like, he's helping me out by taking that work off of my load. That's what he's doing. But at the same time, when he does that, he's taking the responsibility that goes with it. So it's not that he's the whipping boy. It's just that he's the one that's helping out with that. So it's not, I mean, someone else would be the whipping boy, I guess, if someone else was helping with that. I don't know how else to put it. He's not a whipping boy, though. I really hope he doesn't feel that way. Jeez. I really hope he doesn't feel that way. Wait, Durf, you built Bib Yoda and Keyboard Cat. Oh, yeah, I'm checking your upload creations on Steam. Yeah, man, I built a lot of... if you check out the Homer, this one's playing La Cucaracha. Mr. Wobblequack is there. The Clown Car. Except people don't like the Clown Car. I don't know why you don't like it. Anywho, let's get this uploaded to the workshop. Reset. We're just gonna weld Pikachu. We're gonna weld, guys. Did you know we're gonna weld? I only said it like 5 times. We're gonna weld. Yeah, we'll just weld them any old place. Do you ever say a word so often that it starts to like lose its meaning? When you hear it audibly, it just doesn't mean the thing that it meant before. That hasn't happened to me yet. I have to say weld significantly more times for me. weld. Okay. This is the Pikachu build that I'm going with. Reset that. This is what I'm uploading to the workshop. I'm kind of upset that I didn't actually stay with the Poke Center idea. I wanted to build a Poke Center, and then as soon as, because I can use logic to check the player position, so as soon as the player is inside the Poke Center, the music would start, and as soon as you leave, it would stop. To me, that probably would have been better than this Derpichu, but whatever. It's a Poke Center. Music. Why is there a rewind button when it doesn't matter? There's no context in a short loop. There's no context of a rewind button. Why'd I put one? Why did I put one? Doesn't matter. I also gotta check which parts this thing uses. Yeah, it's modpack beta, polygons, and modpack. The big three! Okay, set that to public. And add those required items. What? Some of the things you guys say in chat. Paint the giant K green. What, Marcus? It wasn't supposed to be a K. Okay, here we go. Mod pack. Mod pack polygons. And mod pack beta. The big three. And if I'm missing anything else from this build, I don't think I am. But if I am, it's probably just the legacy support. It's always the legacy support. Polygon, mod pack, beta. Yeah, that's it. So yeah, this was, this was fun. and I will have some more music creation. So if you have any suggestions, actually leave them in the comments section of the VOD, the video on demand for this stream. Oh, this, I gotta get this thing going again. Yeah, but leave your suggestions for new songs that you want to see built in Scrap Mechanic in in the comments for the video on Got any theories on mod support with survival? I imagine that the initial survival release is going to be a lot like the initial challenge mode release, where there's probably not going to be a lot of like a lot of mod support. It's probably going to be moddable in the same way that the data folder is moddable, like in the same way that I can make night mod, I can probably still mod things in survival mode itself, like the survival mode files. But I don't know if there's going to be like a Steam Workshop support right off the bat. I don't think so. And like, it's just in general, like I think just in general, the developers and the modding community sort of want to focus on vanilla scrap mechanic for a little bit. Well, me in particular, because I want to focus on the development of the Scrap Mechanic Mods website, where it's going to like be just a bunch of databases and tools for individual parts. This is really, really annoying. This is like so... Oh my gosh, if anyone can actually withstand like 15 minutes of that in the background, you are a god. Oof. Hey, Scott Dalbeck, how's it going? You want a shout-out, please? I mean, you got it. You got it. Speaking of shout-out, let me go ahead and put that background music back on, but let me go ahead and get a shout-out to all those new members, which, by the way, we got a new Giraffe to welcome to the herd. First of all, thanks to I'm Going to Bed for all those random anonymous, quote-unquote anonymous $1 donations. But hey, we got Giraffe. We got Giraffe to thank. It's Moonbow, the brandest, oh my god, brain stopped working today. I recorded a video and now I'm streaming and now I gotta edit that video that I recorded. Brain and no work too good. So anyway, we got Moonbow, newest Giraffe of the member of the Giraffe herd. Thank you so much, Moonbow, for the support. Snagsnail, Mr. Partisan, Delta, Jor200, Eat Your Cereal, all members of the Giraffe herd. And then we got I'm Going to Bed. He's a tall Giraffe boy. He's a tall Giraffe stretching that neck. Stretching that neck so high, very high. Scott. Yeah, Scott. Giraffe. Giraffe. All right. That was good. That was good. I have. What do I have? I was going to say something and I completely forgot. Oh, yeah. It was about the Scrap Mechanic Mods website. Yeah. I gotta go work on that. I have nothing to say about it. Nothing to say about it other than I can't... the future of mods, actually. Scrap Mechanic Labs, if you're still in there wondering about future of mods, survival mode and things like that, what the plans... What I was talking about, like those databases and stuff for Scrap Mechanic Mods website, we want to make like a mod pack generator type of thing. So I don't like how the Steam Workshop basically worships the stuff that... the famous mod makers make, because like it makes it harder for newer mod makers to actually get into the game and get noticed. So part of the reason this database and mod pack generator is going to exist is so that we stop having this central quote-unquote mod pack that is just by us, right? There's going to be a public top voted mod pack. You can browse all the parts by rating, by UUID, by size, the you know, if is it 1x2x3. So many useful tools. But anyway, I'm just going to cut the stream short here because I took up all my time already. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys who knows when. Who knows when I'll see you guys next. But leave your suggestions for new songs and builds and whatever in the comments. I'll see you guys next time. Bye. We show up in the party, fire than everybody. We show up in the